So I talked with Coach Moore today. Funny thing is, I didn't have much to talk about with him regarding his team. Well, because we just did this a week ago, they haven't played a game since then.
Yeah, since the Rhode Island game on the 11th, I believe it was. And we've had a time off for our final exams, and we've practiced seven or eight times since then. Anxious to play tonight up here at lovely and scenic Niagara University.
All right. Talk about, before I get into your team, it's the topic du jour today. Everybody's been talking about it on this program. What happened with the UConn women? 89 wins in a row. I was asking Howie about it yesterday. Try and put it in perspective. I'm sure you've met Gino during the time that you were at the University of Connecticut. Try and give this some perspective, if that's even possible.
I think it's really hard, Jay, to put it in perspective. I think on any level, high school, college, men's, women's, Division I, II, III, it's just like it's really difficult. It's a phenomenal, obviously a phenomenal, phenomenal accomplishment, and it speaks to, you know, the level at which he has that program, the level of sort of dominance that he's had, that he has that program, and it takes a great coach to, you know, not only do they have the point where they have the program at the point where it is the place to go to if you're a top five, top ten women's high school player, that's the place you want to be offered a scholarship to, I would assume. And so it's one thing to get great players, and they put in great recruiting classes on top of great recruiting classes. It's another thing when they get there to also mesh them, blend them, get them to all buy into their role. And then it's another thing, better yet, to coach them every day and practice so that they're staying on top of things that they need to improve on and they don't get comfortable. And that's, as a coach, I think that's what every coach can really appreciate about this streak, is the nuts and bolts and the daily grind that go into being good. You know, I'm sure there's been other Division I women's teams over the years. Tennessee had great runs, and Old Dominion had great runs, and different schools over the years, Louisiana Tech and the Cheryl Miller USCs and all those. But no one's done it to this level, you know. So along the way, each one of those programs stubbed their toe against somebody, or let up against somebody, or took something for granted, or whatever. And it's incredible that he's been able to do that to the level they've done it at. It's just a phenomenal accomplishment.
I'll say this too. I've watched a lot of basketball players in my life, male or female. There are few in this country, in this world, and I don't mean to sound like I'm overstating this, that are better than Maya Moore. She is simply amazing. I don't know how much you've ever gotten to see of her, but some of the things that she is able to do, I've just never seen a woman's basketball player do. And her ability to see the floor, you know what needs to be done. She scored 41 last night, Tom. She scored 41 last night. That was the easiest 41 I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah, and you know what? I did get a chance. We got up here last night, and we ate an early sort of team meal, and I was in my hotel room. And I turned it on. I was able to catch some of it. One of the things that impressed me, I went up to a practice earlier this year, and we had a day off because my daughter is 13, and she wanted to sort of see a game or a practice or something. And Gina was nice enough to let us in. And one of the things that strikes me about her, too, is she's got great size for someone in the women's game. You know, she's a three. Maybe sometimes they play her as a four. But she's got great size and strength as well. So I think physically she's hard to guard. And then you take the fact that she's good with the ball and she's smart and she can shoot. You know, I think the best thing seems like she does is shoot the ball. She shoots it with touch and with strength. And she's very impressive and really fun to watch. And it's nice that all the women's basketball fans in the state seem to really be appreciating and enjoying her career, because – you know, I always felt Diana Taurasi was the best one that I saw come through there.
She's better. I'm going to tell you right now, Tom, she's better than Diana Taurasi. She is.
Yeah, well, I don't see him enough. I just during my time when I was an assistant there, I thought Diana was, but I've watched Maya probably less. I was more up close and personal with Diana during my time there. So, but she's very good. I don't get a chance to see her much, but when I do, it's quite clear that she's a cut above everybody else she's playing against.
Talking with Tom Moore, head coach Quinnipiac men's basketball, gives us a few minutes on the back page, our weekly spot with him on the Shaler Acura Hotline. All right, you saw Niagara against CCSU, coach, and you started to see signs of life, by the way, that CCSU might be turning a corner a little bit, just in terms of the way Kenny Horton's playing and what he's starting to be able to provide to that team. But in terms of Niagara, start there. What did you see, and what is going to be, you know, one of the sticking points for you tonight?
Well, Niagara's they're a scary team, Jay. They're 3-8, and they've played a good schedule. This is a team that we had a shoot around this morning, and I was looking up in the banners up in the rafters here at the arena, and they've made the NCAA or the NIT, I think, 5 times in about the last 7 years. So Joe Mihalik's done a really good job making this probably close to an elite MAC program. Now, I think we've caught them this year, and Central caught them this year, in a little bit of a rebuilding phase where they graduated 2 or 3 great players a year ago. They've been a little bit banged up. One of their key players is out, Antoine Mason, and he might be coming back tonight, we've heard, but he's out, and Anthony Mason's son. And they're a little young, and their depth isn't where it normally is. He's been rotating about 7 guys in. And they're very inexperienced. I think they're I saw a stat in their notes, they're the 20th youngest team or something in the country. But they're very athletic. They're very tough-minded. They play very hard. Now, they've been a very inconsistent shooting team. They've been a poor rebounding team, and they've been a little bit inconsistent defensively too. But they've continued to play hard, and they're very athletic, so they're going to pose a huge challenge, and this is a tough place to play up here tonight. And what I saw in the Central game is that they're just starting to shoot the ball a little bit better. They're making their free throws, and they're making more threes than I've seen them make in earlier.